So Lydia, you've been working on this conference since the beginning, pretty much. How has it been and what has the process been like for you?
It's been an amazing experience. It's been fantastic to work with everyone on the committee. It's really cool that it's super multidisciplinary, so yourself. We have Dave Fahey, we have, Cleona, Luke, Mike, Tomas. So we really have someone from all different areas of science and then also science communication and everywhere else. So it's been a fun experience to have that and then also to have the exposure to all the speakers as well. It's been amazing to pull together such a great lineup and see it all come together.
Is there anything that's been explored in the conference that's been particularly relevant to you and your work?
I work in Tomas's lab, Tomas Ryan's lab, and so we are a neuroscience lab. We're based at Trinity, and then we work on memory. And much of this conference has been dealing with the concepts that we are looking at. So we're investigating, where memory is stored in the brain, and so a lot of the speakers have touched on something that may not be exactly relevant, but really close. So we have emotion, consciousness, all of those things are really near and dear to the neuroscience field.
Tell me a little bit more about the research that you do in your lab.
We use a multidisciplinary approach, and so we're looking at where memories are stored and recalled in the brain, and so we look at it from a behavior perspective, from an electrophysiological and then also molecular biology perspective, and so we're trying to pinpoint on all those different levels if we can find exactly what's happening when we're storing a memory and then also when you are remembering something again. And so we work on animal models, but they have great exposure to humans.
So where do you think that research will go in the future?
I would love to see it unfold, and neuroscience is really in its infancy, and so I think it's an exciting time because we are just starting to get the tools to be able to explore these things like consciousness or memory. So I think it's going to be amazing what happens in the next few decades, and so I just want to follow it, hopefully be a part of it in any way, whether that's reporting on it, being part of doing the actual research. I'm not sure yet. So.
And what about Schrödinger and what is life? Has that influenced you in any way? Is it something that, before working on this conference, I had some knowledge of it, but obviously we've been really thrown in to getting an in-depth sort of understanding of what Schrödinger did. How
Absolutely.
Has that been for you?
Yeah, well, I think the whole what is life topic is just resonates really strong with the conference itself. And so all the speakers are obviously on one level. They're talking about what is life and what the future of their field holds. But then there's also a second level where they're all scientists. So science is an endeavor to kind of understand the world around us, maybe, a little bit more about ourselves. And so I think for me, that's been the thing that's rung true the most, or rings true the most, is because it's just really interesting to be part of science and this whole conference where everyone's exploring and seeing what's coming next.
So Lydia, you chaired one of the sessions at the conference. Tell me a little bit about that.
Yeah, it was a great session. We had Svante Paabo, we had Ada Yonath, and then we also had Beth Shapiro. And so they were all talking about ancient DNA or ribosomes, and we had Neanderthals. And so it was really interesting to hear about their take on all of that.
Lydia, thank you so much.
Great. Thanks, Sean.